Hi folks, today I'm going to show you how I make my bacon and egg quiche casserole. It's very easy to make, it's easy to flash freeze and to reheat. So to start my prep, I'm going to be using some thick cut bacon. I'm just going to do a whole sheet pan worth here because I can use this with other meals. I'm only going to be using three of these thick slices in this one casserole, but remember, double, triple up, depends on what you want to make in bulk. I'm showing you how to make one of these quiche casseroles, but you can make two, three at a time, depending on how many you want to put in the freezer. You can use thin sliced bacon, it's totally your choice. It's just what I prefer. While the bacon was cooking, I'm going to saute some onions. And butter. Just remember that when these thaw, we're going to create a lot of water in the pan, and then they'll dry out. So I usually put the heat at medium high to saute the onions. See how wet that gets? Look at all that water. I mean, butter isn't even all melted yet. Look at all that water. That's gonna cook right now. And when it starts to cook down, that water evaporates. It goes quickly, so you have to watch your onions and lower your heat promptly. See? No water now. Now I gotta put the heat down to medium. So I'm going to brown these up a little bit and then they'll be done. Believe it or not, one of the easiest things to make is homemade pie crust. All you need is flour and butter and some water. This here, I know it looks like it's very hard, but I had this thawing out in the fridge for a while. These were pre-frozen pie crust pucks that I had in the freezer. So it's still really, really cold. I'm just trying to really work it here to soften it up. And all I need to do is to get it into a shape to fill my casserole pan. So I actually need a rectangle, not a circle. I'm just gonna try to get this a little warmed up and get it into a shape that I can put on the bottom of my casserole dish. I do have a video in my playlist that says two kinds of quiche. And in that video, I make the pie crust in there. So take a look at that video. If I don't have a video up that just says how to make pie crust, then check out that video. I also, in that video, I make a tuna quiche. And remember, when you're making quiche, you can put anything you want in a quiche. You can use any kind of meat or vegetable. It's totally up to you. This recipe is very forgiving, so what I do with this pie shell, you know, I'm just making it work. It just needs to be underneath my eggs. I'm just patting this all around. Just make sure it's not too tight on the bottom because this is gonna shrink up. This will shrink up in the oven. I really only need it for a base, and the eggs are going to be beaten eggs on top, and so it's going to be like a souffle on top, and this is going to work really well. And here we go. Just going to pre-bake this in the oven at 325 degrees for about 12 minutes. And while that's baking, I'm going to get my egg mixture ready. I'm going to use 8 large eggs in this recipe. I find doing it in this order is the best way. First, put all your eggs in. Just take a fork or a whisk, whatever suits your fancy, and just beat them up. Get them nice and fluffy, and then we're going to add the liquid. Now, the recipe calls for 1 3/4 cup of whole milk. I don't have any milk in the house, so I'm using my table cream, and I add water to it, and basically it does the same. So I'm adding this in, and then I'm going to whisk it up again. Having light, fluffy eggs in this casserole is one of the secrets to not having a rubbery egg when we reheat this at a later date. Add your seasonings. I'm just going to add a teaspoon of salt. How much salt you put in is absolutely up to you. And I'm going to do 1/4 teaspoon of pepper. Again, how much salt and pepper you put in is totally up to your taste. Then we're going to add 2 tablespoons of flour. Now, you can also put this flour in your milk mixture if you wanted to before. While that was in my measuring cup, I could have added that to the milk and whisked it in. Doesn't matter, really. Just make sure it's fully incorporated and whisk into the eggs. And this really helps any wetness of the quiche in the end. Okay, I'm just going to put that aside. And you can decide what you want to put into your quiche. And here I go. I've got my 3 strips of the thick sliced bacon. If you're using thin sliced, I would use probably double this. So maybe 6 slices, and just cut them up into little squares, little bite-sized pieces. And this is where it comes in. You know, if you wanted to use ham or something else in your quiche, maybe some turkey, or, you know, if you were doing a dinner, I find the bacon and egg is nice for breakfast. So that's why I'm choosing to show you this recipe today. The pie crust is heated and pre-baked. See how much has shrunk down? So here I'm just going to add all the sautéed onions, and I'm going to try to spread them as evenly as possible. When the egg goes in, it will kind of try to float these things around, but I try to keep them as equal as possible, because this is going to be cut into 6 or 8 pieces when it's finished. And then just add the bacon pieces evenly across the bottom also. Now just pour the egg mixture in slowly. If you just dump it in too fast, everything will just start floating, and sometimes you'll just get clumps of your onions and bacon in one spot, where I just try to do it a little evenly to keep everything intact. Whenever I'm doing a quiche or souffle, I always like to have a pan underneath just in case it puffs up and spills over. You don't need that on the bottom of your oven. So now I'm going to put this in here and we will add 2 cups of cheese. .325 for about 45 minutes to an hour. And here is the finished product. Okay, so 45 minutes to an hour. This actually took me an hour. And what you do is just take a knife and at about 45 minutes, poke a knife in. And if it comes out clean, it's done. But when I did it and I poked it in, it was all wet and full of egg mixture. It was after an hour that when I put my knife in, it came out clean like this. So then you're good to go. Just take that out of the oven and let it rest for 10 minutes before you slice into it. This here, if you're going to freeze all of this portion, just let it all sit in here until it cools and then cut into your portion sizes. So you can cut this into 8 pieces. Those are pretty, they're pretty small pieces, depending on the appetite of the person that is going to be eating this. But 8 slices is going to give you basically 1 egg per serving. And for this one here, though, I'm going to cut it up into 6. So this is the same amount of quiche in here then that would be into a deep dish pie plate. So I would do that into 6 pieces. So here I'm going to show you cutting it into 6 servings. And there you go, look at that. Nice, firm, but it's fluffy. One thing you don't want with your egg dinners, anything that you're gonna freeze, freezing eggs, you can tend to get a rubbery texture from eggs after, reheating them after they've been frozen. But this is more like a souffle and it's light and fluffy and that's how it reheats in the Hot Logic afterwards. Now, flash freezing this, you would take each individual piece, put it on a pan in your deep freezer and freeze them up and then wrap them up individually and keep them in your freezer until you're ready to use them. I like to serve this along with some pan-fried potatoes and I'm going to show you what that's like heating it up in a Hot Logic. All right, I have the Hot Logic here and this is 3.5 hours. Actually started at 10:45 and it's now 2:15. So it's 3.5 hours. I opened this and tested it at 3 hours. And the temperature of the quiche was at 142-ish, 144. Now you're gonna have condensation on the top, which might make things a little watery on the bottom. Depending on what kind of food you have is whether or not you want that. So I'm gonna temp this. .157. So if you wanna go to .165, you'll be looking at 4 hours. This is .160, .161. 62, that's for the potatoes. And the bacon, really, you just have to reheat your bacon. I can't really temp the bacon much. All right, so for me, for now, this is fine. I'm gonna tell you what it tastes like. All right, so for me, okay, this is hot on the bottom. You can take this out and put it on a plate, or you can eat out of here. Let me just get a fork. Okay, I'm gonna take some of that quiche. This was my bacon and egg cheddar quiche. It's got the pie crust on the bottom. That's a good temperature for eating. Very good. Now I'm gonna taste the potatoes. These were the pan-fried potatoes. They're not wet. They're just heated through. It's not soggy at all. I would put some ketchup on that. And then the bacon, this is thick bacon. Farmer's bacon. Ooh, that piece is hot, it's underneath. I made that crispy. The fattery part there is a little soft, but it's okay though. And it tastes really good. The crispiness is gone, but that's thick bacon. And that's why I like the thick bacon in here. It's very meaty. Yeah, the quiche is great. Tastes really good, heated up. Everything, the consistency, it's just like you made it. Okay, so this is what your meal would be like after you heat it up. Perfect breakfast or lunch or even dinner. And this, I would say if you want this to come up to 165, then it would be 4 hours, and that's because that was a solid piece, thick solid piece of quiche that was frozen, and then deep frozen. Not just in my refrigerator freezer, that was in my 0 degree Fahrenheit freezer. Okay, so this is for a taste test to show you what this is like. And check out, if I haven't done it already, I'll be giving you an idea, a taste test of the chicken pot pie. And just to let you know what this is really like, okay? I hope you enjoy these videos, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye for now.
Make sure to search my playlist for the video for my pan-fried potatoes.